In this video, we're going to learn all about how to add client logging with MetroLog to your .NET MAUI application. If you've ever released an app or maybe whatever piece of software into the wild, then you know how important logging is, because the users, whenever something is not happening, they try to help you, but it's not really helpful to you if they say like, I press this button and things don't work. It doesn't really tell you what's going on, right? So you have to have logging in order to know what's going on. Ideally, have those stack traces, your own log statements in there, and that's exactly what you can do with MetroLog. Now, MetroLog is a library that has existed for a long time. I think it's a drop-in replacement for nlog, which is drop-in means that, you know, the method names and all the things are mostly the same, but the implementation is different. So MetroLog has existed for a long time, built by other great people, but now my good friend Jean-Marie has created a new plugin, especially for .NET MAUI, compiled against .NET 6 for, you know, the same purpose of logging information. Now, in this video, we'll see how to implement it, how to do console logging, well, trace logging, basically console logging, write it to a file, maybe even touch upon how to attach it to an app center kind of crash log thing, so you can also transport it to outside of your app. A lot to cover here, so let's just quickly dive in and see how to implement all this goodness. So here we are in Visual Studio 2022. This is just a file new .NET MAUI application. You can see it running here. The .NET bot is waving at us again. Hello again, my good friend. So let's just close this down, the running application, because what I need to do first is, of course, install the MetroLog NuGet. So let's right click on our project right here. I'm going to say manage NuGet packages. And then here I can find MetroLog.Maui. Now, like I said, there's also, you know, just a .NET 6 variant of it, so you can use it with other .NET 6 applications as well. It doesn't have to be MAUI, but we're going to look at MAUI right here. So let's click that one. Let's click install, and then it's going to pull down the NuGet packages. It's going to install that on our .NET MAUI project, and whenever it's installed, we can just start using it. So here you can see all the original authors: Matt Baxter Reynolds, Claire Novotny, Jean-Marie Alfonsi, who is my great friend from France, and he has been creating this. So it's installed right now, and basically you're good to go. So like I said, this very much connects to, you know, the generic host builder and that kind of stuff. So if we go to our MauiProgram.cs, we have this generic host builder, right, where we can initialize all of our stuff. The same is true for logging. And if we set it up this way, it automatically works with the dependency injection and all that kind of stuff. So if I do here builder.logging, we have a dedicated logging section, and I can here say add, and you can see that it comes up with a couple of things here: console logger, in memory logger, streaming file logger, and a trace logger. And of course, you can also, you know, add your own provider if you have your own target. Totally customizable, totally up to you. If you want to write something in a special format or to a special thing, that's totally up to you. You can do that, but this is like the built-in targets right here. So the console logger is a little note. This writes to the console of the actual device. So in case of iOS, that they had the dedicated log thingy. For Android, it's logcat. And you know, for each platform, there is a dedicated thing. So it's not going to do it to the console write line, basically. That's the important thing. For that, you will want to use the trace logger. And whenever we add one, we have here the ability to specify some options. So we can do options here, and then we can configure more options, which is mostly, you know, the minimum level. So we have a couple of log levels, of course. We have the trace, the debug, the information, warning, error critical. So you can define all kinds of levels and let them go to different targets if that's what you want. We also have the maximum level. So that's kind of like, you know, whenever you have log statements in your code, only the ones that are specified here in this min and max level are going to be put into this trace logger right here. And I think we have something for a short category where it will use the short category names whenever it's outputting something. But I'm fine with the default options. So I'm just going to do this little discard thingy, and now we have set up the trace logger. Now, if we want to use the dependency injection, of course, we also need to add our page to it. So add transient so that our page is registered as well and it can actually receive the dependency injection. If you want to know more about dependency injection, a video should pop up on your screen right now. So now we've set up our main page as well, and now I can go into the main page right here and I can specify whatever I want to receive here for the dependency injection. So let's make this an ILogger. Now at the time of recording, I'm not sure if this is a bug. A bug is logged for it, an issue on the repository. But you have to use this one. Let me finish typing here first. So you have to do this ILogger variant using Microsoft Extensions logging. So make sure to add that. And then you need to do ILogger with like the angle brackets here. And you need to specify the type in here. This will be used to kind of like categorize the log messages, and it will also show in the log output. If you just do the ILogger, I think, which is totally possible, so you don't get that category information, but it gets a runtime error at the time of recording at least. So if that's something that you're interested in, make sure that it's fixed by the time that you want to implement this. But for now, you can just do this with the type. But you know, this is probably also what you want, because now it gets nicely categorized in whatever type you are getting these log messages from, right? So that's probably something you would want. ILogger main page. So let's get this in here in our in a little field logger, and now we can put this logger is logger, and now it's ready for use. Right now we can start using this logger everywhere. So if I copy this and do it to the little, this is the event that happens whenever we click on the button and we do the count plus plus. So let's just add here logger dot log. And we see all these levels, right? Log, critical, debug, error, information, trace, warning. I think you can do some custom stuff here as well. But this is like an information thing, right? This is just informational, nothing special here. Let me specify something. So a little string interpolation, button clicked. And maybe you want to also now say count. And we can incorporate the count in here, right? So we can see that it actually counts and does something here as well. So now we have our first log statement set up. So actually, let's just run it. Let's run it on Windows again. This works on all platforms, of course. So it's going to deploy to Windows. And whenever we see it come up, I think we should already see a couple of log output thingies here in the application output, because it starts logging and it sets up loggers for different things. But whenever we click the button, then we also should see our own custom log information coming up right here. So here we are, the application is coming up, and let me see the application output here. Oh, this is not the right one. Here we are. See, here you can already recognize these logs right here in the output. So it has even a line number. It has the date of today, new log manager created. It creates new log managers for different things here. And whenever I scroll it down and I click the button here, you can see that there are new lines added here in the background with the click count that I can see come up here. So this is kind of like your basic logging, but this only goes to your output right here. But it can still be very valuable whenever you're debugging things, right? So this is in here, but now let's take it even a step further, because one of the cool things that you can do is actually have this little shake to get a crash report kind of log information. So a shake to give feedback kind of thing. It's built into this plugin, which is really cool. Now, what we want to do for that is we're going to have to add a new logging target. So I'm going to go over to my MAUI program and if you want to use the kind of like shake to layout, it will become clear whenever I actually show you what's happening. We have to add the in-memory target. So the in-memory one will just, is this right? Add in-memory logger, there we are. Also here we can configure options with how many lines need to be preserved and that kind of stuff, so that it doesn't grow inside of your memory application. But we need to enable at least this one. And if you also want to share the log, so you know, if you shake, then you will get a page. You will see kind of like in a text window the in-memory log messages. But we can also have the streaming file one that I just mentioned, right? So let me actually just copy and paste this line, and we can also dot add the streaming file logger. Again, you can configure like the file path and a couple of other things for that one. But with this one, you could also get a share button in that same window. You can tap the share button and you can send it through email or do all kinds of things. So I add these, which is fine. And now I need to kind of enable that page whenever you shake it, right? So there's a couple of things you need to do with that. For that, we have the log component. controller. So go into your app.xaml.cs. You can do it somewhere else if that makes sense, but I'm going to paste in some code here. And this log controller is a static thing, and you can say initialize navigation because this is a page that is built into the MetroLog.Maui package. So that page is there. You can customize the page if that's what you want, but we need to tell that page how your navigation is working inside of your app, right? You can have different navigation stacks. You can have different navigation frameworks installed. So you're going to have to tell this log controller initialize navigation. And in this case, you know, we have two parameters, the navigation function. So how should the page come up here? And we can just say main page, which we set here, dot navigation dot push modal. So we're going to push it as a modal. And the second one is to pop it again. So we're going to say pop modal. And then you have a third option, with which you can actually specify like your own shake to show the log page thing. But we're going to skip that for now. You can find all about that in the documentation. So we've got this set up. Now, one thing which personally I find a bit odd, I'm going to tell Jean-Marie that as well right after recording this, but you will have to add the is shake enabled basically. But the way you should do that is with a kind of built-in view model. So if I go to my main page, let's go here. We have to kind of set this binding context. Is new, and this is that same logger controller. Log controller, there we are. So new log controller. And inside of this log controller, if we inspect it, bar foo is new log controller, and that's the easiest way to get all the IntelliSense here. You can see that it has all these properties, right? Can get compressed logs. So you can also get compressed logs, and it will compress all the logs that it has into a zip file, and you can send it as an attachment to maybe your App Center logging, right? That's totally something that you can do. Close page command is shake enabled, right? That's the one that we're after. So you have to enable it through this instance of this log controller, which makes sense if you're going to create kind of like a settings page. You can put this in here, but you know, it would be nice to also have this little static option, I guess, so that you can is shake enabled without having this log controller. So for now, I'm just going to set this binding context. If you want to know more about dating binding and MVVM, something should pop up on the corner of your screen. Let's get back to the main page .xaml, and I'm going to add a little switch here that will switch the is toggled the shake to show that actual page. So is toggled is true. No, I want to set this to binding is shake enabled. All right, so I got that set up. Now, whenever I run this, of course, I can't run this on Windows because, you know, that doesn't really work. I can shake my machine, but it's not going to show the actual page. So I have my local device, my physical device, because I found the shake was very hard to mimic whenever I did it on the emulator. So let's run this on Android. And while this is running, I should be able to pop up my screen right here. So I'm going to deploy the app right here. I have this physical device, which I should be able to unlock here. And whenever the app is deployed, then I should be able to hit that switch to activate the is shake enabled. And I probably want to tap on the button to generate a couple of log messages here. So let me just do that. Click, 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 click. It's behind my little camera here. Click, 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 click. You can see it come up right here. And then whenever I tap the switch, it's not really visible here in the top right. I put the switch on, and then whenever I shake it, you can see that a new window comes up, which is built into MetroLog.Maui. And you can see all the log messages right here. And I can close it, or I can do the share logs, and I can share it to someone nearby. Bluetooth, this is just your built-in share dialog, right? Which will pop up on iOS, Android, all the things, and you can share it to whatever you want. So whenever you know kind of like your customers, you can instruct them to shake the device, get this little dialog out, share the logs with you, and you're golden. So that's how to get started with MetroLog and .NET MAUI. Now, it's a bit hard to create a video on this besides just showing you the mechanics and how to implement this because, you know, it really depends. I think if you're working on a consumer app that goes through the App Store, then you don't know who is going to download your app, right? So this shake to actually show this lock screen is very useful, but you can't really reach your user that downloaded your app through the App Store and say, hey, okay, try to shake your device and please send me the locks. That's not something that's realistically going to happen. So then you would have to tie this in with services like App Center to actually retrieve those locks. Of course, a very important note, just don't go logging everything. Please be sure to check the local laws and whatnot, GDPR, that you're not collecting any stuff that you shouldn't be collecting, which is very easy to do if you're just logging all the things, right? So please make sure to do that, and especially if you're sending it to App Center and whatnot. But if you're in a more enterprise environment and you probably do know the actual users that are running your app, then it totally makes sense to implement this screen, right? You can just, maybe they're tech savvy enough to scroll through the logs and see what's going on themselves, or they can very easily share it with you. You can enable these things by little feature toggles if that's what you want whenever you're trying to debug a very specific problem on a specific device. So there is loads and loads of options with this, but it's so cool that this hooks into like the generic host builder, your .NET MAUI app. It's just minimal configuration, it puts it in there, and you have this logging enabled inside of your application, which is really, really cool. Thank you so much again for watching another one of my videos. Please click the like button so that it will spread through the YouTube algorithm to other people who might be interested in .NET MAUI, .NET, C#, all the things, logging, maybe logs, I don't know, it's not really relevant, but maybe someone likes to chop trees. And of course, make sure to check out this playlist for more .NET MAUI content, this recommended video, and click here to make sure that you're subscribed so I'll come to you automatically. See you for the next one.